皆さんこんにちは、 T です。本日はなんとスマブラの世界の絶対王者あのゼロからお話しする機会をもらったので、個人的に気になる話題を選んで、まあ、質問していきたいと思います。また後日上がる動画ではゼロと僕とでね、オンライン対戦をした動画が上がるので、そちらもぜひ楽しみにしてください。ではどうぞ。Hi, Zero.
Hello, how's it going?
Hi. じゃあ今からゼロにインタビューをいくつかしていきたいと思います。でまずは、軽く自己紹介をお願いします。まあ、僕なんかは絶対知ってるんですけど、まあ、スペシャルから始めた人もいると思うのでお願いします。
Okay, so, before we get started with the interview, can you, have an introduction? A little bit about yourself, since, a lot of Japanese smashers started from, Ultimate.
Okay.My name is Zero. I'm an old school Smash Bros. Player at this point in time. I used to be the best player in Smash 4, most commonly known because I won 56 tournaments in a row at a point in time. I won Evo, I won Genesis, a lot of the big tournaments, I've won them. I've also played Melee and Brawl, and I used to be up there with QB-san. So I guess maybe that'll give you some context if you know QB-san. But I guess that's about it for now. And you know, now I'm a YouTuber slash streamer.
こんにちは、ゼロと申します。僕は昔からスマブラやってる方で、うん、特にスマブラ 4WiiU では一番世界ランキング1位を取った、うん、方です。ジェネシスとかエボとかいう大きい大会も全て優勝したこともあり、まあ、スマブラ X からやってて、あ、デラックスもやってましたね。そこら辺の実力は、まあ、当時の X のキュービさんくらい、うん、強かったと思ってます。で、今は、スマブラ 4U1 位取った後に引退して、現在、YouTuber、配信者と YouTuber の活動をしています。
本当に、ずっとぶっちぎりで一番だった。
あ、そうですね。あと56大会連続で優勝してるので、うん、
このプロは。16、あ、56そんな言ってた。
56くらい?
Yeah, 56.
Was it a Guinness record?
Yeah, it's a world record. It's the longest winning esports streak of all time.
56大会、世界記録らしいです。ゲームの大会。
ギネス持ってたっけ?
Was it a Guinness or not?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I have the frame right there in my living room.
ちゃんとギネスの認定もあるらしい。
そう、ギネス知ってたわ。聞いたことある。
すごいよ。
すごいっす。レジェンドプレイヤーよ、も
レジェンド。
レジェンド。
お、Thank you。
じゃあ、2問目。じゃ次の質問いきます。そんな、ね、めっちゃすごい人なんですけど、ゼロは。そのゼロは、なんで選手を引退して、まあ、そういう配信者とか、フルタイム配信者かになったんですか
?So, you probably might, got asked many times about this,、mm-hmm. but, why did you, stop competing and decide to become a full-time streamer?
So the reason is a little bit complex. The reason I decided to retire is simply because I started playing competitive Smash when I was 10 years of age. And I stopped playing when I was about to be 24. So if you do the math, for more than over half of my life, I've been competing in tournaments. And what it came down to is that I was like, well, I am heading into my 30s and the only thing that I've done in my lifeis play competitive Smash, you know, so I decided that it will be a good idea to do other things. At the same time, I feel like my passion for competitive play was getting lower, and I didn't want to stop seeing something that I enjoy so much, which is Smash. I wanted to have fun with it again. And now that I play for content and I just have fun, I'm loving the game more than I ever did because it's less pressure. And I'm also having a lot of fun doing what I do now, and it's beenDoing really good.
ではまず実は10歳の頃から大会とか出始めてて、はい、引退した時は24歳だった、うん、その計算をすると、まあ、言ったら14年なんですけど、うん、気づいたら人生半分以上スマブラの大会、うん、選手として活動してたってことで、このままずるずる、選手として30代とかになったらそれしかやってない、うん、人生で。ただそれだけじゃもったいないと感じて、さらに、やっぱり長年やってたこともあって、なんだかんだで大会に出るモチベ、情熱がなくな、薄れてきたと感じたんで、うん、でも、自分の大好きなスマブラを嫌いにはなりたくない。そう思って、また別の道を考えました。で、配信者と、まあ、YouTube とかでやることによって、まあ、もともとあったプレッシャーとかも感じなくなったし、まあ、結構楽しくやっていけてますと。
うん。 やっぱり、やっぱりプレッシャーが強かったんやな。
どうしよう。Yeah, so、うん、he's saying like, yeah, you must have gotten many, lots of pressure during your competitive time.、
Mm-hmm.
So、mm-hmm. you're feeling more relaxed right now.
Yeah, it's also about the it's also important to know that if I did play Ultimate competitively,A lot of people will expect me to be the best player again. When anything but the best player in the world will be kind of seen as a failure. So it's just too much to live up to. That for me, it, you know, in a position where I was, where I wasn't the most passionate, it just wasn't a good spot to be in.
I see.
Yeah.
でもし、スマブラ、SP スペシャルを新作やってたとしても、もう絶対みんなから、うん、あの1位でないとダメとかそういう期待がするじゃないですか、うん、皆さんこの情熱が薄れてる中1位でないといけないっていうのをちょっと荷が重いかなと思って、うん、やらなくてちょっと良かったなと思
ってまあもうそうか僕なんかは今ランキングが上げていくぞって感じでモチベーションがあるんですけどやっぱり自分より上がいないっていうのはやっぱ追われるっていうのが一番やっぱしんどいんかなって思いましたね
So right now, he is in the opposite situation as you. He is currently climbing to become the top player.
Right.
So he has lots of passion.
Yeah.
To get the top spot.
Mm-hmm.
To go to the top spot. So he's like saying, yeah, the situation is different and he's kind of understanding how it feels to be like the top.
Yeah. In a lot of ways, I guess you could say I'm old. Definitely when I was younger, my passion was really high. I remember when I played in 2013, I played the best players in Japan, which were Otori-san, Rain-san, Kara-san, I mean everybody really. I don't think Yubi-san went to 2013. Actually, he did. I think he did. But regardless, when I played with everyone, it was really fun and I had a lot of passion to beat them.So、I definitely feel that, you know, what he's feeling because, you know, he's competing in America, you know, he's playing with everybody and all that. And when you're kind of like on the come up, you're like trying to beat everybody, it's so much fun. So I definitely understand.
自分がスマブラ X やった時に、
はい、
T 君と同じような立場にいたんですよ。
はいはいはいはい、はい。
あの2013年に、多分 Apex だと思うんですけど、あの大鳥、レイン、かけらさんとか、キュービさんとか、うんその人たちと日本人と対戦して、本当に楽しかった。情熱もモチベもすごく日本人たちを倒すぞ。情熱が T 君の今の状況を見てるような感じ。
うん。今はね、楽しいけどね。じゃあ、次の質問。配信者になって良かったことと、まあ、悪かったこともまあ、あるかもわかんないけど、まあ、あったら教えてほしいです。
Okay, so since you became a streamer,、
mm-hmm.
What's like the best thing that happened to you? And then what are some like, some bad, is there any bad things about it too?
I think the best thing that has happened is just the explosive growth of my community. Like I definitely went from having maybe, you know, a couple hundred people watching. And then at a certain point in time, we had like over 30,000 people watching at the same time. You know, we hit 1 million subscribers on YouTube recently.So there's been a lot of growth within the people that watch what I do, and it's been wonderful. I don't really have anything to complain. If anything, I think the only negative is that sometimes it's hard to come up with interesting things to do because, you know, I feel like we, as in like, you know, yourself, we're not always interesting, right? So then, but you have to be constantly interesting and funny, and that's challenging in a different way. Not like in a tournament challenging, but it's just,You have to improvise a lot, and that's a different skill set to have.
基本的にやっててすごく楽しいし、最初からやってた時と今となっては、このコミュニティのどんどんどんどん大きくなっていくのがすごい楽しい。あの最初数百人しか見てなかったのに、最近なんかもう数万視聴者とかやってて、
すごいな。
まあチャンネル登録者も最近100万になったし、ゼロがやってることを見てくれる人がどんどんどんどん増えていくっていうのが、まあコミュニティのためにもなるし、自分自身も楽しいと。で、まあ言うほど悪いことは、ないんですけど、はい、毎日ネタを考えるのが結構大変らしくて、
やっぱり
動画として残るので、うん、面白くしないといけないとか、みんなが面白いと思えるような動画を毎日毎日考えるのは結構やっぱり大変ですね。大会の違った大変さ、
そうね、
となります。
っぱり YouTube そこか。俺も人事じゃないんだよな。
He's like, yeah, I need to come up with lots of ideas too for my YouTube business.
Yeah.
Yeah. じゃあ次いきますか。ありがとうございます。
Okay, so the next question. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. とじゃあ、ゼロのスマブラスペシャルでのメインキャラクターと、あと使ってて楽しいキャラクターを教えてほしいです。
Okay, so let's get some questions about the game.
Mm-hmm.
Currently, who do you have a main character? And then, besides your main character, do you have a character that you enjoy playing in general?
I don't really think I have a main anymore, simply because I haven't really put enough time with anybody, significantly over everyone else. Because I mostly play this game as a content creator, I pretty much put my time on a lot of characters. For example, just to give you a random statistic, my third most played character is Villager, which is very strange because you would not expect me to be a Villager main. I think in terms of skill-wise, my best characters is anybody between Diddy Kong, Cloud, Wolf, and Mario. And if there's a character I had to pick that's really fun for me, it's always Mario because I can play very stupid and it always works even against players like Leo.So I have a lot of fun playing in weird ways and having it work.
今は現在そのメインキャラいるかどうかっていうと、どっちかっていうといない。ほとんどスマブラはその大会はもう出てないので、動画を配信するためにスマブラもやってるって、例えば今見てみたら3番目に使ってるキャラって村人らしいんですよ。
村人。
なんか俺が村人使うのってあんまりイメージできないよね。
そうだね。
でもただ実力的にキャラを絞るといえば、ルーフ、マリオ、
クラウド、
リリカ、使ってて楽しいのは、マリオか。
マリオ。で、マリオ今一番熱いんじゃない？
なぜかというと、うん、割とそこまで考えなくても、変なことしても結構通るらしいの。あの、レオとこの前マリオで対戦したら、意外と通って楽しかった。
マリオね、一番今もう来てるんじゃない？
Yeah, he's also saying Mario, he's, He used to be underrated, but he's currently getting up into the radar in Japan also.
Yeah, he turned out pretty good, huh?
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Let's go to the next question.
ゼロが今、現バージョンで最強だと思うキャラクターと、あと、トップ5教えてほしいです。
Okay, so this is another interesting question.
Uh-huh.
So in the current version, who do you think is the best character? And then, do you have like a top 5 in your head?
If I had to pick a character who I think is the best, I think the character with the least amount of flaws is probably Pikachu. He just doesn't really have a single part about him that I can say it's a real weakness. He just doesn't have, I want to say, like a whole lot of broken stuff. Whereas, like, for example, a character like Joker may have Arsene. So that's like an easier thing to pinpoint of something that's more super strong, right?But Pikachu just seems much more flexible than Joker. Other than that, I feel like the best characters in the game is honestly a mix between like Joker, Pikachu. Man, I will have to look at the characters, but Peach, those three. And then depending on who you ask, it's a combination of like maybe Snake, maybe Fox. It's kind of a toss up after those three. But I feel like the three best for sure is Joker, Peach, Pikachu.
Okay. このゲームにおいて弱点が少ないキャラが一番やっぱ理論的に強いと思うらしくて、
なるほど、
その中で一番弱点が少ない、いろんな全て補えることはピカチュウだと思うんですよ。
ピカチュウ
で、まあやっぱりジョーカーとかアルセーヌのおかげで目立つと思うけど、僕の中ではピカチュウが飛び抜けてるかなと思ってます。でトップ5決めるのはちょっと難しいんですけど、
難しい、
3つ挙げるとすると、はい、ジョーカー、ピカチュウ、ピーチらしいです。
やっぱりなんか日本とアメリカではキャラクターのいる数も全然違くて、なんか評価も分かれるのかなと思ったけど、そうでもなくて、やっぱ日本でも評価高いキャラはどこでも強いですね。
Yeah, he says, since in Japan and America, there's like a big difference in like the main character, like the top player's main. So he thought the meta would be kind of different. But what he's thinking is, he said it's similar.
Yeah, I think one thing that I think we lost between the older Smash games and the newer Smash games is that in the older Smash games in Japan, you will have these really unorthodox characters that will be doing really well. But in Ultimate, it seems that a lot of people play the same characters, or at least very similar. I think T is actually one of the like more unorthodox people that play different characters in Japan. But in America, Japan share a lot of the same best characters like Joker, Peach, very common. The Zero Suit, for example, Wolf, you know, all these characters are just very common. But I also think it's because more people play Ultimate, so there's less character specialists.
Japan and America, では結構違うのに、ただ目立ってるキャラは、あの、似たような感じ、あの、ゼロサムとか、ウルフとか、ピーチとか。で、まあ単純に人口が増えたこともあって、その上位キャラがどんどん増えて、そっちが目立ってきたと思います。ただ T 君とかは、まだ、あの、レアキャラ使いとして、まあ珍しい方だと思います。
か。最後に、最後じゃなくて、まあ、聞きたいんですけど、パックマンは何番目ぐらいですか？パックマン。
He says, hey, what do you think about Pac-Man?